Mini chapter 73, the Platinum Raven's appearance comes alive. Jaymi settles himself in the shade behind the house on Zeus Drive, near the swimming pool colonnade, a white neoclassical pastiche that encloses the far end of the pool in a semicircle. As a beast whose incarnation will constitute the richest communication he could have with the world, the Platinum Raven deserves to have her appearance equipped with three final accoutrements to give it that subtle sheen of three-dimensionality. "You know that sheen," he calls aloud, addressing the hill slopes below him. "Sure you do." Swaying in a sudden breeze, the tall green fingers of Italian cypress wave across the canyon at him, like Amber's fingers waving at Kelly in close-up through her car window. Frowning, Jaymi rubs his eyes, then refocuses them on his screen. Okay, first, he establishes his new beast's gleaming detail in the Platinum Raven as being a particular pair of windows, whose visuals will scan the game world. Quote, "High upon the turret of the mad-faced tower, there are two round windows, tinted with swirls of brown inside the glass itself. In one of these, the Platinum Raven stands, looking down from the hills and out across the desert plains, ellipsis. She returns to the circular window, ellipsis. She gazes through the deep squirly brown of the glass, out across the desert, to the city and the ocean. She eases her feet further forward on the wide sill, onward through the thickness of the high turret's walls, and extends her limbs to touch the round embrasure's edges all at once, ellipsis. Her name squirling through the condensation, independent of the squirls in the brown itself, ellipsis. Floorboards run away from her face, from out of focus close up, across the turret room to the pair of round brown windows, through which she can see it's still dark outside. Ellipsis. Just below the two brown turret windows, silver mist belches out, flows across the terrace, past the pair at the parapet, billows through the balustrade. Unquote. Echoing the opera glasses he established earlier as a talisman for Kim, but doubling those, Jaymi next establishes the Platinum Raven's talisman in the Platinum Raven as being two pairs of binoculars, whose visuals will fracture the game world. Quote, "The chocolate raven braces both her elbows on the railing, holds up a pair of binoculars and trains them on the tower. As she fine-tunes the focus, an unexpected seahorse shimmers in from the haze and stands sharp. Ellipsis. Easing the sightline upwards minutely, she almost drops the glasses in shock. For there's the Platinum Raven in one of the round brown windows, holding up binoculars directed straight at her. I see you, the latter mouths in silence across the desert miles. Then she winks and turns away. The chocolate raven flicks the glasses down, alarmed and guilty. They aren't allowed, as very well she knew." Unquote. He concludes by establishing the Platinum Raven's additional motif in the Platinum Raven, or perhaps her first platinum blonde foreshadowing there, as a white rabbit, whose visuals will portend the gameplay's rabbit hole. Quote, "A small white rabbit, curled up peacefully upon itself, right here in the rabbit-sized space between her boyfriend's body and her own, in a state of semi-sleep like their own, its eyes half opening and its perfectly white furry head and ears making slight movements from time to time before its eyes close and its head and ears become still." Unquote. Jaymi puts his finger to his lips, as if bidding the cicadas fall silent in all their spiky succulent crevices of vegetation around the terrace. Although she has no soundtrack yet, he's beginning to sense what sort of beast the Platinum Raven will be in her game. She will feel her beat permeate each member of a roomful of people when she walks in. Through them, she will look around the world in all directions, and the shafts of her seeing will illuminate the things she sees. She also constitutes at least the basis for a response to the art score, simple smiley or complex frowny newsfeed, he would hope. When he stares at her eyes on screen, it's as if a cooling system inside her causes them to ice, their pupils turning glacially clear. Peering further in through this cold clarity, Jaymi discerns a landscape of inexhaustible flatness, like a vast plain, dark and cold and fiery all at once. And striding across this plain is the unmistakable outline of himself, designing and building her. How isolated he looks, there inside her platinum exquisiteness, within that vertiginous isolation of hers. But something else about this spectre of himself strikes him too. Truly, there is something demonic in the beast-building energy he's exhibiting here in the creation of her. Cutting through her night, he is like a blowtorch or a switchblade.